I guess we're starting here. So enough with that. Enough about me. Let's talk about Stash and Cora coming in. And I've been seeing Stash go a lot of Crom today. What do you think? Why do you think he's picking the Palutena for this match?
It's probably just easier. Like, I'm pretty sure Crom can deal with Violet pretty well. But I mean, like, why go Crom and just go Palutena?
Well, I think the main thing that stands out to me about this matchup is, like, trying to catch the tethers. Palutena's really good at doing that with her nair and with her down air.
Even the explosive flame, too.
And explosive flame, you know, if he's able to, if he has the time to turn it around.
Yeah, Palutena has a lot of options, to catch the tether grab.
And also, gonna, you know, he could catch Cora sleeping like that. And Palutena, I think, even past the nerfs and everything, I don't think she's, like, S tier anymore, but I do think she's very easily top of A tier. I think she's still a very good and
she's
very viable
character. Yeah, that's what I was saying. She has everything you need to be a really good player overall.
Yeah, she just takes a little more work. It's, you know, you have to do everything she does for, like, 5 more seconds.
The key word, the key word there is little, because, like, the thing is that this character loss is huge in a way, but not as much where it's like it makes like the character like unplayable or like.
Oh yeah, no.
Like,
no, what do you have?
Well, I mean, she was like top two in the game.
What she had before was just a, like a plus, I feel like.
Yeah.
Already more than what she already was. You know what I mean?
Well,
like
I think.
Nair, for example. Like, he was pretty super early. Like,
yeah. I think before.
Well, you're talking about the first nerf that she got like a long time ago.
Well, I mean, it's been the combination of nerfs that's kind of put her where she is today. I mean,
that is true.
Before DLC, I think she was very close between everybody saying, you know, it's Pikachu and Palutena are top two very easily. You know, characters in the game. I think, you know, they did some very small adjustments to Pikachu, but did a lot of major adjustments to Palutena. I think just for popularity's sake. But I think they put Palutena in a very good spot, and Pikachu's is just not popular enough. And I don't know why. He's not popular enough, but people just don't play Pikachu.
He's showing us why the pillow's working, right?
And honestly, one thing that I noticed, I played with Stash a little bit at the watch party for Kazuya's announcement. And one thing I noticed is Stash really feels comfortable playing off stage. He's not afraid to go super deep or like super neat underneath the stage to go get whatever kill he needs.
Stays aggressive
too. Yeah. He's not one to wait on stage and kind of ledge trap. He wants to keep you off in disadvantage and get his kills as early as possible.
Yeah, Stash kind of got his whatever you say, like his fame in the RC for the way that he keeps you in advantage. Like, he had probably one of the best advantages the whole state, honestly.
Really?
Like,
okay.
As you were seeing in that last game.
He just keeps on pushing.
Juggling, you know, Violet up in the air. And, like, we have a switch now where Cora decided to go to Violet.
Yeah.
I can't really see this being any better, honestly. Like,
I just don't see the offstage game being there.
I think that's the biggest problem. Like, you know, I don't think the neutral play was a problem, but, you know, of course, it's probably hard to say that because, like, he didn't really get to play neutral.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Stash doesn't.
It's working.
I just, what does Pyrite do there? What is she supposed to do at that point? You know? Like, once Palutena gets off stage, she just has to wait. There's nothing. She can't go out there unless she has to contest Palutena off stage.
That's true. I mean, and also being a teleport character, like, it already makes it kind of hard. Like, you know, usually the best way to deal with a teleport character, like, you know, off stage, is either like boomerang, being able to have some kind of move that like extends where they don't have to worry about that. But of course, you know, Palutena player or any teleport character just go over and like land like that, so you don't even have to worry about grabbing away,
That just gives so many, that just removes the disadvantage state from what Stash has to worry about. I mean, once he could fall into that. Well, and I think that it's still, I think it's possible. I don't see, oh. Well, I would say that now, all of a sudden, Cora has a pretty good shot at doing something with this.
you hate to see stuff like that, but like you're a player, you're playing competitively, you just gotta keep on playing.
Yeah. And Stash very easily could still bring this one back. It's not out of his reach at any point in time. But maybe, you know, that's part of the, you know, reckless aggression that Stash is able to push. He's just able to keep going, and sometimes you miss that step. But I don't see what she has to do here.
And see, that's the thing with this switch. I feel like Violet, like, Quirr was able to get Stash to last off here. I feel like he did play a little bit better than the Violet, but I still feel like the problem there was, like, disadvantage. Like, he was just juggled up in the air with up air, off stage, you know, hit with everything, and then, like, you know, right there, that last part, you know, trying to use side B to recover, it's just like, oh, I'm just going to hold up smash. It's like, there's nowhere for you to go.
And one big thing, you know, Korra, you saw that he was playing Link over there against Reninu. His Link and Dark Pit is actually what he won his PCC with. So I think, not necessarily the pits, but I think Link actually doesn't have a terrible matchup for Palutena. His disjoints and his projectile game is actually, I would say it's slightly Palutena's favor, but at best I would say it's.
I would agree. I feel like
you should give it a try. He's already
too down. Korra's known to play a lot of characters, Link, Bowser, Piss, as you said, and you know, like he's going Bowser. To the Link right here.
See, and where I feel this year, I feel like up tilt is gonna be really important for Link to try and catch her, you know, jumping nairs, that disjoint that he's gonna be able to have. Of course, nair is gonna be really important to try and stuff whatever approach that he has. But I think he needs to really focus on trying to put the bomb in his face. Have that stage control and have that zone control where he doesn't have to worry about, you know, worry about a platform, worry about it from half the stage. And he hasn't thrown a bomb yet. He's thrown one boomerang and had it reflected. But like that right there, one of the big things that you can do with Palutena is you can catch her teleport with the bomb if you bounce it on that screen. So there are options that Link does have in this matchup that he can't get stuffed out. That's the biggest thing. He can't get caught slipping into the smash, and he can't get, you know, nared with it.
As someone who's played Stash a lot since this game has come out, if you ask almost any player who knows Stash, they'll tell you he's one of the best people at punishing you for your habits. Right there, you see he caught him with a jump. Like, he just knows. This isn't just guessing. He takes time to learn, understand between games. In between sets, like.
Oh, and I was off the bomb too.
Yeah, that was.
And again, Link has amazing advantage state and probably one of the best ledge guards in the game, or ledge traps in the game, and it's caught with a random up smash. But again, I think that, you know, one of the things that I was. Ooh.
That's it. Why?
It's best of five.
That was three.
Was that three?
Yeah,
it was three separate characters.
Two down there.